No. No. So long as you promise you'll never tell anyone you've told me. If ever it came out.
I've written it all down.
What?
Like pretend. Like a novel. Want to see it?
To read it and send it back with comments, and then ideally have nothing more to do with her. And I would have done, but for one thing, the one thing I didn't anticipate given the amount of slush I've had to read over the years.
It was something someone handed to you on holiday. It's witty, it's insightful, it's human, it's remarkably competent considering it's not come from anyone we know, and it's mainstream, left of field. It's precisely our bag.
Thank you. No. What? Nobody knows anything other than the fact that I met you on holiday and I wanted to stay that way.
I always knew this was going to happen.
What?
I always knew I was sent to the planet for something big.
Yeah. Bigger than you.
No doubt.
Oh, you think I'm joking.
I think you've had about 15 glasses too many.
And I'm celebrating. You're going to publish my book?
Yeah. Well, it's not quite as straightforward as that.
What?
We want to publish it. But we'd like you to take another look at the end.
Why?
There's a feeling that it doesn't go far enough. The Julie character is living in the middle of nowhere, kind of lost. And the Ian character is in prison, reformed, possibly, contrite, religious. But we feel it lacks closure.
Do we?
We have to think commercially.
Don't just churn it out, you know.
Oh, I know. I can tell that. You talked about visiting him.
Yeah,
which I'm not suggesting you should do, not for a second, but can you imagine if you did? Does that help? If the Julie character did visit the Ian character, does that suggest any possibilities to you? Plot-wise. Where it might go.
You will recognize me, Ian, because I have long blonde hair and glasses. I would send you a photo, only I haven't got a recent one. I am thinking about you, as I often do. Looking forward to meeting you no end. Love from Susie.
Visiting.
Lock it up for us, would you, Mr. McDonald? Only you wouldn't believe the life-finger rough mucks they get in here.
Which one's this one, then?
This one?
It is Susie. And she's reading sociology at Bristol. And Susie would like to reform me, rip me trousers off, and just flower me.
I'm Susie. Are you all right?
Yeah.
What's the matter?
You.
What?
You look like her.
Who?
Julie.
Do I? In what way?
Just
Your eyes. Your face. Everything.
Ian. You're freaking me out.
You would sound like it.
Do you want me to go?
No. I thought you'd go anyway.
Would you want to sit down?
Absolutely not, under no circumstances. That was not the deal. Look, when have they ever... Sorry?
Mommy,
no, of course not, But look, this is my second draft. Based on extensive discussions with everyone, including them. No,
my point is...
I'm just gonna...
Are we joyous? Not desperately. What are you doing here?
I went to see him.
I wonder if it's a bit.
Hey?
You thinking I look like her?
Julie had a mole.
Did she?
Under her left tit.
Did she?
Yeah. Which I don't expect to whip out. Not here. But... she also had one on her cheek.
I've always had that mole.
Julie.
You're freaking me out. I'm not Julie.
I knew I couldn't have done that to anyone. Where have you been?
I live in Devon.
I know, I should. Don't fuck me about.
Ian.
Didn't kill you.
You're raising your voice.
It was you. Writing to me all this time. It was you.
No.
It mustn't, Julie.
I was really looking forward to this. I'm not Julie. Julie's dead.
I'm sorry.
What?
Oh, Susie. I'm not right at the end. You do really look like her. And you know more than anyone how much I was in love with her. Still am in love with her. Now... staring at you and you look just like her.
She's just sitting there.
Get in the line, bottom lady.
Why aren't you listening?
Get in the line.
I'm doing 15 years for murder and she's dead.
Move it now.
Why aren't you listening?
Right, get him out of here.
Stop her. Arrest her. Question her. No, I didn't tell you. You can't just let her go. I'm going to get you. You mad bitch.
And then they just handed me back my handbag and I left. They didn't even ask me any questions.
Are we eating or what?
These kids are going bonkers.
Is it all right if I stay?
I've been writing to her at an address in Devon. At least check it out. At least get somebody to go down there and check it out.
Bottom Lee. Your wife's dead.
It's... the thing at the end. It's... you like it. It's... clever. Uncle, I need a new name. I've loved the Susie one.
I'm going to find out about getting you an advice.
Wait. There's just...
what?
Well, with me being dead and so forth, I'm not registered for tax, etc. So, how's your firm going to pay me without it looking like they've been cooking the books?
Of course, I couldn't share the problem with anyone at work. Not without them knowing the truth. So, I set up an account. In the name of Tracy Moon. The plan was that Julie would use the account, then I would declare her income on my tax return. As if it was my pen name. I couldn't see any other way of doing it. And then, something happened.
I've had four agents slavering after me.
You're hot, you're sexy, what do you expect?
One of them was banging on about selling the rights to Hollywood.
It'd make a great film.
Make a brilliant film.
Make a fantastic film.
Especially the end. True, yeah? Obviously. Only who'd play me?
Play you, Flonker. You wrote it, you're not in it.
Oh, yeah.
Congratulations on the book.
Hello.
So excited.
I am, yes. This isn't a publisher.
Oh,
so,
oh, hello.
Oh, yes, we've met.
Yeah, yeah.
How are you doing?
No.
Really?
You talk the same.
You do, Susie.
Did you really meet each other on the beach in Devon? Really, really, really?
No, look. In a pub. In Devon.
So we both got Yorkshire accents.
Do you know how big Yorkshire is, Jess, love? Right, you know Texas.
Julie!
Who's looking at you, kid?
Bye, Jessica.
You are gonna be so rich,
Hammer.
So fucking rich.
Listen, I know I'm drunk and everything, but you know what? Hey, thanks. Thanks for not going straight to the police. When you could have done. You were too good for him.
Hello.
You know, last week, at the book launch...
Yeah?
This thing happened.
What thing?
I was talking to Susie Tracy, and we were drunk, and she said things.
What things?
Things that made me think and wonder things. I've got it in my head.
Go on.
Do you remember?
What?
I remember it because of the thing about pronouncing the word.
What word?
Sorby Bridge. Your friend, who died. Do you remember? In the paper, whose body was never found. It's exactly the same story in the novel. You and Susie, Tracy, you talk the same. Exactly the same. Not everyone from Yorkshire talks the same. Not everyone from anywhere talks exactly the same. Not unless you really are from exactly the same spot.
Okay, you're right. I did know her before. We were at school together. And the reason I didn't make that known was because I didn't want people here to think that... We're both new. Julie, the woman that disappeared, that got killed. We were all very close. We were all close, good friends. And the reason I didn't make it known that I knew Susie at school was that I didn't want it to look like there was any kind of nepotism going on. So...
You called her Julie? When you got the cab the other night?
Did I?
Look, I...
No, I...
The thing is...
What?
I looked him up. On the internet. He has a website. He knows she's not dead and he's desperate to be taken seriously. He's been in prison for 10 years. And she's not dead.
Yeah, I realise it's
not... I realise that. He was probably horrible to her in some way for her to. And I don't want to get anybody into trouble. On the other hand, we're making money out of it.
Julie's dead. Is not Julie. You say you heard me call her Julie? Well, I can't account for that. I don't know why I would have said that. Well, unless I had it in my head, what with the book and everything. I mean, they were not unlike Julie and Susie. We were all part of the same... Jessica, accept what I'm telling you. Susie isn't Julie. If the shit hits the fan, this is what I've told you, and you believe me. How about that? Or you can shot me. And I mean, it's up to my neck, frankly. And yes, he did ask for it. Arguably. You don't have to live with it. Just forget about it. If you find yourself dwelling on it, just tell yourself it isn't your problem, all right? It's mine.
Relax.
You could just disappear again. I can't. I've got children.
If she's going to keep a gobshop.
Yeah, but maybe one day, just one day in a few months' time or something, she'll decide she can't live with it anymore. Then what?
She'll have denied it, for sure defence.
She knew. However much I might have denied it, she still knew and would still be in the same boat.
I'll sort something out.
What do you mean?
I'll talk to her.
Yeah?
Where does she live?
Are you going to go and see her now?
If she's in Archway somewhere. And I couldn't just disappear again, by the way. No more easily than you could. It's hard work, and I'm tired of it. And I've got more to lose than you do if she does say anything. Kids or no kids. Think on. Something.
It's Jessica. She was knocked down last night. She's dead.
Where?
Near her home. She must have been coming home late, and she came out of the tube and hit and run.
Jessica to the Almighty's merciful keeping and commit her body to the ground.
Jessica was 29. She'd been engaged to Jamie and they were due to get married next summer. Jessica was the youngest of three children. Her parents, David and Jill, were devastated. They were good people. Ordinary people. Not quite what I'd expected. Jessica was knocked down and killed outright at 27 minutes past 11. Approximately 20 minutes after Julie'd left our house. Less than 4 miles away.
Look at this face, and it's all mine.
Answer the question.
Oh, come and live with me. Bring the kids. Leave the fat bastard.
Did you?
What you don't know isn't going to hurt you, so stop going on.
Did you?
Grow up.
Beg your pardon.
Why? What have you done?
Answer me.
I think I could do that.
Well, it's a bloody big coincidence.
I was protecting you.
You didn't.
That's right. I didn't.
You did.
I did. I didn't.
Who knows?
Nobody saw it. Came out of the tube station and she walks across the road. She was right there, right in front of me. Dippy as shit. Saw an opportunity and I took it.
I don't want to know this.
Well, too late, baby. You shouldn't have asked. I have not come this far. Just to have it all snatched away because of a bloody curse word from you.
Are you going to bump me off next?
No. I don't need to. You won't shut me. You're in too deep. And anyway, you love me.
Don't count on it.
Oh, for God's sake, I lied. I lied! I didn't really do it. See if I would. Come on. Let's go and drink some champagne somewhere.
I've got to go back to the office.
Later then.
Post. First book. Plot is ingenious. The suspense, breathless. The end, shattering. This is my story, and it's all true. It's the story of how I disappeared one night in April after a fight with my dozy, feckless twat of a husband. And how he got banged up for life because everyone assumed I was dead and that he had killed me. Tracy Moon was born on the French Riviera in 1961. She now lives in California and is married to a humanitarian multimillionaire who has eight children, five grandchildren, and a pet chimpanzee called Ian.
Ultimately,
your wife's dead.
She wrote this novel.
Dead people don't write novels.
Exactly. So she's not dead then.
Bottomley, you're not doing yourself any favours.
Every detail, every page, it's all what happened. It's exactly the same. There's things only she'd know.
Another 5 months and you're looking at parole.
Read it.
But that's not going to happen if you don't show some remorse, which involves you accepting that your wife is dead. Okay.
She mind you coming to see your old man?
I didn't ask her.
So, Nathan, lad, did you buy a copy?
I believe you.
Do you?
Yeah.
Nobody else does.
Well, neither did I. Before. I do now. So what do you want me to do?
Find her.
Then what?
Nothing, just find her.
What are you gonna do?
Can I trust you?
Yeah.
Can I?
You know, we have a very nice life here and everything, but I have this notion, this idea, this thing. Actually, just to spend more time with the kids.